is 1 cup moong dal, half cup oatmeal flour, 1 tablespoon ghee. This is cold ghee. You may take butter. Then we'll be taking 3 tablespoons of olive oil and 1 to 2 tablespoons of milk. 1 tablespoon of milk and a pinch of salt. And this is jaggery powder, 3 to 4 tablespoons jaggery powder. So let's get started with making moong dal cookies without any raising agents. So the idea is to first add in the butter and olive oil. We'll begin with the creaming process. Alright. Now we'll be adding the jaggery powder. We'll be giving it a good whisk. Make sure your jaggery powder is dry, or else you can run it in the mixer grinder. I have already done a video on how to make jaggery work for baking recipes, so do check it out. The creaming process is very important for cookies, especially the no raising agent ones. See, I have taken a mix of ghee and olive oil. You may replace olive oil with ghee, or you may take olive oil instead of ghee. Now we'll be adding milk. I'll measure it for you. This is 1 tablespoon. Mix it again. Okay, now we need to sieve the flours. We will be sieving them directly into the wet mix bowl. This is dry roasting moong dal powder. I'll do a separate video on how to make this powder at home. Gently mix it. Okay, so I think my dough is already looking perfect with moong dal. So I'll be reducing the amount of oats. Let's see how much we need for this batch. We'll add a little more amount of milk to our dough. So this is a live experiment, so I have gone wrong with the ingredient list, but that's okay. We'll be correcting it now. I have added 1/4 cup of oatmeal, 1 cup of moong dal, 2. Okay, so we'll need little more amount of milk. Let's see. Okay, so this is 1 tablespoon, we'll be adding it. Just gently mix it with hands. Look at the way how I am doing it. I'm not kneading it. I'm just ensuring that everything is mixed up well. You don't need to knead it. Else you'll get chewy cookies, and our idea is not to make cookies chewy. Alright, so we'll cover it and rest it for at least 20 minutes and then we'll bake it. Okay, so let's see how our dough looks like. It's almost 1 hour since we kept the dough for rest. See, moon lentils disintegrate. So it's a very difficult dough to handle. So this is how this is what you need to do. I'll be air frying these cookies. So we need to preheat the air fryer for 5 minutes at 170 degrees. Meanwhile, we'll be rolling out our cookies. Because if you try to roll out the dough, it'll break. Since there is no gluten, so we need to manage it like this. And even once the cookies bake or air fry, you will need to let them cool down properly before removing them from this basket, otherwise they will disintegrate. Moon cookies taste very good, but this is a trick you need to employ. Okay, so our lentils are ready for baking or air frying. I'll be air frying it at 170 degrees for 10 minutes. So this is my air fryer. Okay. We'll be adding these. Okay, so we are ready for air frying these. We'll be air frying these at 170 degrees. This is 170 degree for 10 minutes. We'll check. And do remember not to try picking any of the lentils until they have cooled down completely, otherwise there is a high risk of them breaking down.